Decision analysis. This video introduces decision analysis. What is decision analysis? Business analytics is about making better decisions. Decision analysis is used to develop an optimal strategy when a decision maker is faced with multiple decision alternatives and does not know with certainty the results each alternative will yield. For example, P and G used a decision analysis technique to choose the best brand name when they introduced the Crest White Strips. They evaluated different naming options and examined the potential sources of uncertainty. Decision analysis is decision making under uncertainty. Another type of decision making under certainty is where we know exactly the results each alternative will lead. We will discuss decision making under certainty in another module. For now, we will focus on making decisions when we do not know for sure which alternative will lead to us. Let's look at an introductory example. Please pause this video here and read all the text on this slide. The company needs to make a decision on the size of the apartment complex they should build. There are three different sizes: small, medium, and large. There are three alternative actions the company can take. The consequences, also the payoffs, associated with the alternatives are uncertain, as they depend on the future demand. A large complex appears to be more profitable than a small complex when the demand is strong. On the other hand, a small complex is a better choice than a large complex when the demand is weak. So the optimal strategy depends on the market condition, which is a future event and is unknown when the company makes a decision. This type of a problem is known as decision making under uncertainty. In decision analysis under uncertainty, there are four elements: alternatives, also known as actions, state of nature, payoff, and probability. An alternative is a course of action intended to solve a problem. In our example, the company may choose to build a small, medium, or large apartment complex. There is a total of three alternatives. The state of nature is the outcome of the uncontrollable future events that affect the final payoff. The company faces uncertainty about future demand, which can be weak, medium, and strong. There are three states of nature. The payoff is the outcome measure of each combination of a decision alternative and a state of nature. If the demand is high, the company builds a large complex, the payoff will be $8.5 million. The last element, the probability, is the chance of a state of nature will occur. In our example, all three states have an equal chance to occur. That's 1/3 for each state. Let's see how we can better organize these four elements and summarize the information to facilitate our decision-making process. Payoff matrix presents the relationship between alternatives and states of nature. Note that the payoffs are calculated to be the net payoff, that is revenue minus cost in our example. For example, under strong demand, when we build a large complex, the total payoff is $8.5 million. We also list the probabilities of each state of nature at the very bottom, and they are 1/3. Regret matrix is another way of organizing the information. Instead of showing payoff information, this matrix shows the opportunity loss of a given alternative under a given state of nature. For example, when the demand is weak, from the payoff matrix, we can see that the best action is to build a small complex. If the company indeed builds a small complex, there will be no regret and the opportunity loss is $0. However, if the company builds a medium complex when the demand is weak, it loses $0.3 million when it could have made $3 million by building a small complex. The difference between these two payoffs is 3 subtract negative 0.3, that's equal to $3.3 million. The opportunity loss is the difference between what the company could have made if the best action is taken versus the actual payoff. Unless the company takes the best action, the opportunity loss or the corresponding entry in the regret matrix is always positive. Please pause the video here and try to calculate the opportunity loss or regrets for the remaining of the matrix. A more flexible way of organizing a decision problem is to construct a decision tree. A decision tree is a graphical representation of the decision problem, showing the sequential nature of the decision-making process. Compared to the payoff and the regret matrices, decision trees can be easily expanded to much more complicated decision problems that involve more than one stage. We will go through some examples in the later videos. In this class, we will learn to use a computer program to build a decision tree. To read a tree, we start from the very left of the tree and follow each path to explore all possible scenarios. Along the path, we may draw a square or a circle. A square is a decision node where a decision or an alternative action is made. In our example, that would be whether we build a small or large complex. When we face uncertainty or a random event, we use a circle to represent a random event. This circle is known as a chance node. An easy way to remember this is that all possibilities should add up to 100%, very much like a pie, so we use a circle to represent a random event. In our example, we are not sure of the future market demand, so the three different states of nature, weak demand, medium demand, and strong demand, are all branched out from the circle. The last set of nodes is a triangle. It is used to indicate the end of a decision process. All nodes are connected by branches. There are lines showing the alternatives from the decision nodes and the outcomes from the chance nodes. When we draw the decision tree, we also present payoff and probabilities in the tree. To avoid confusion, it is a good practice to record and keep track of cash inflow and outflow that happen between any two nodes. Suppose that a company decided to build a medium complex. That is, the company follows the middle branch from the decision node on the very left to reach a chance node. There is a cash outflow of $1.3 million. This number should be recorded between the decision node and the chance node. If later the demand turns out to be medium, then there is a cash inflow of $6 million. This should be recorded between the chance node and the terminal node. To calculate the final payoff of $4.7 million at the terminal node, we simply add up all the cash inflows and outflows along the way to get a final payoff. This concludes the introductory video of the decision analysis. In later videos, we will go through the single-stage and multiple-stage decision problems where decision trees will be used to help us to find an optimal solution.